distract you. You know, which everything has its duality. As touching the spirit, you know, certain things arise for us to consider, you know, and if it applies to you, then you repent and you move on. But for others, they're going to be distracted by certain scenarios, which our Lord Yahweh Shai himself has forged, if you will, has created and formulated and designed. And it's all an effort to snare the undesirables from amongst us, which when you consider a snare or a trap, if you will, is designed to distract the prey. You know, for the most part, when you consider a trap, it comes with a bait. Case in point, a mouse trap where the cheese was set up in effort to draw in, to lure in the rat. And through his lust, he's distracted by the trap itself. Until bam, he's taken. So in essence, distractions is nothing more than a trap, nothing more than a snare. And this is why the scriptures encourages us to just move forward, to continue to press forward towards the mark, pretty much to keep our eye single. Matter of fact, let's start off real quick right here in the book of Proverbs, the 4th chapter. And starting at the 25th verse, it says, let thine eyes look right on, and let thine eyelids look straight before thee. Yeah, let's read this again. It says, let thine eyes look right on, and let thine eyelids look straight before thee. So we read in here where the scriptures is encouraging us to not be distracted. You know, again, obviously concerning the things of this world, anything external or outside of the ministry, but more so things that